Good morning. We're coming to you broadcasting live from the Chapel of Molloy. On behalf of the Maris brothers, Principal Penicus, and everyone at Molloy, I would like to welcome you to our Thanksgiving Liturgy. Clearly, 2020 has been a year like no other. Today, we are streaming to you live at home, on the internet, and broadcasting to several smart boards at the school. For many years, it's been a tradition at Molloy to welcome our alumni back on homecoming weekend. We typically have over 100 alumni join us in this annual celebration of thanks. Please know that we miss our alumni, and we are praying for you and your families. We look forward to the day when we can greet you in person at one of our many events, such as our annual reunion. We pray for peace during this holiday season. We pray for all who have experienced great loss of a loved one. We pray for the faculty who have greatly sacrificed so that the quality of instruction can continue at Molloy. During this time, we continue to pray for comfort and healing. We pray for our first responders, caregivers, and healthcare professionals who show great courage and stamina so that others could be safe and well. We pray for those who are working on new vaccines and treatments for COVID-19. Even though 2020 has brought us many challenges, we have many things to be thankful for. We are thankful for the support and guidance of the Maris brothers and lay Maris who laid the foundation of who we are. We remain thankful to our faculty who continue to demonstrate fortitude and creativity as we navigate the health and quarantine requirements necessary to operate in COVID-19 reality. I'd like to offer the following reflection. O God, when I have food, help me to remember the hungry. When I have work, help me to remember the jobless. When I have a home, help me to remember those who have no home at all. And when I am in comfort and without pain, help me remember those who suffer. We ask this with the blessing of Mary, our good mother, good St. Anne, and St. Marcellin's Companion. And now I would ask you to join me in welcoming our celebrant for our Thanksgiving liturgy, Father John Serio from the Molloy class of 1971.
United in prayer this morning in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. And good morning to everyone, those who are here in the chapel, those who are scattered throughout the building, those who are at home, current students, perhaps alums, family members, faculty, as we come together as the Molloy community to celebrate Thanksgiving and to give thanks to God. If I wasn't here right now, I'd be doing the exact same thing in my own school, Salesian High School in New Rochelle, where our young men, who are all at home today, are celebrating Mass via live stream with their teachers, and one of our priests and our faculty is celebrating Mass in our chapel right now with the administrators gathered together in our chapel as well. So this is happening in many places, and it is done out of necessity. And like here, we certainly miss our own young men and our alums who would have come back today as well. But wherever we are, And whatever school community we belong to, we come and we thank God for the opportunities, many of which we do not even think about, that God offers to us each day and throughout this year. And we begin by asking God's forgiveness for those times that we have not taken advantage of God's gifts that He gives to us. And we pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us. May God forgive us for the sins that we have committed. May God bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. And let us pray. Father, all powerful, your gifts of love are countless and your goodness infinite. As we come before you on Thanksgiving Day, with gratitude for your kindness, open our hearts to have concern for every man, woman, and child, so that we may share your gifts in loving service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes.
There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for every affair under the heavens. A time to give birth, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot the plant. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces. A time to seek and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to rend, and a time to sow. A time to be silent, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time of war, and a time of peace. I have seen the business that God has given to mortals to be busied about. God has made everything appropriate to its time, but has put the timeless into their hearts so they cannot find out, from beginning to end, the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to rejoice and to do well during life. Moreover, that all can eat and drink and enjoy the good of all their toil. This is a gift from God. I recognize that whatever God does will endure forever. There is no adding to it or taking from it. Thus has God done that he may be revered. What now is, has already been. What is to be, already is. God retrieves what has gone by. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is, Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Blessed the one who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day after day and night. Blessed the who hope in the Lord. He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season and whose leaves never fade. Whatever the Lord does prospers. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff, which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Galatians. We who know that a person is not justified by works of the law, but through faith in Jesus Christ, even we have believed in Christ Jesus, that we may be justified by faith in Christ and not by works of the law. Because by works of the law, no one will be justified. But if I am building up again those things that I tore down, then I show myself to be a transgressor. For through the law I died to the law, that I might live for God. I have been crucified with Christ, yet I live, no longer I, but Christ lives in me. And so far as I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who has loved me and given himself up for me. I do not nullify the grace of God, for if justification comes through the law, then Christ died for nothing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus continued his journey toward Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voice, saying, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. And when he saw them, he said, Go, show yourselves to the priests. As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing that he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice. And he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said and replied, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God? Then Jesus said to him, Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus.
So when I was a senior here, which you can tell was more than a few short years ago, one night I was told by my mother to go and round up my siblings. I come from a large family, and so rounding them up took a bit of time. And as I was rounding them up and bringing them, telling them to come home for supper, we could not find my youngest sister at the time. Her name was Janine, and she was 3 years old. We thought, where is Janine? And she didn't respond to any of our calling. And we went through the whole house. We checked under the beds. We checked behind the couches. We checked in the basement. We checked in the pull-down door from the attic. We checked everywhere, under the, behind the cushions, every conceivable place in the garage. We went to every neighbor's house on the block. We knocked on every door. We went on the main streets and checked in the stores on the main streets. There was no Janine to be found anywhere. And it's getting dusk, and we're thinking, where could she, what happened? What could possibly have happened to her? And my mother says, you better call the police. And my father was on his way home from work, and I was thinking, how am I going to tell my father that we lost my baby sister? And now, In the days when I was a senior here, there were phones on the wall. I know that's hard to imagine. With a rotary dial, and you had to pick up a receiver. I know the current students don't know anything about this. That is ancient history. But I went into a room in the house and to a phone on the wall, and as I picked up the receiver and the light wasn't on, I looked down. My sister Janine had pulled herself up on this chest of drawers and had fallen asleep, and none of us had seen her, and she didn't know any of the commotion that was going on looking for her in the neighborhood. She hates it when I tell this story, but she's not here to hear it this morning. And it was lucky for us, and it was only a little while that she wasn't around. But you know, it made me think that even in a house with 11 kids, we could take each other for granted very easily because of the day-to-day life and the tussle and the arguing, the fighting and noise and all that. We could take each other for granted. And I thought, but what if something happened to her? We would never forgive ourselves because we lost her. And lots of times, we don't think about people around us. We don't think about things until they are gone. And when we have lost them and we cannot get them back. And we think of people and things as part of the landscape. And you know, we're not being malicious when we do this. It just happens to be part of our daily life because you don't always pay attention to the people, things, and events that go on right around us. And we take them for granted. You know, we think that our parents, for example, will always be with us. We think that whether we are kids, we think that when we are adults. We think they'll be always there until God calls them. And whether we are 16 or 66, the feeling of loss is the same. And could we have one more opportunity? And we didn't forget them maliciously, but we take our parents sometimes for granted. In these months, we have this way of life that perhaps we have taken for granted. The ability to come and go, the ability to freely do this and do that, not to be hindered by particular regulations. We took that for granted until March 15th came along, and now we're all in masks. We have desks in the cafeteria and in the gym. The same thing is true at Salesian High School. Our whole way of life has changed, not only as students, but as family members and as citizens of the United States and of the world. Perhaps we took our freedom of movement for granted. And now this is making us think about it and take our lives with a little bit more seriousness, perhaps, or perhaps a little more gratitude. As students and as young people, we can take our education for granted. We come to Molloy, it's a great place. I work at Salesian High School, it's a great place. And as students, we come and we see our teachers, we deal with our friends, and we don't realize necessarily the sacrifices that our parents make and the sacrifices that our faculty and administrators make for us to go to such great places. A few weeks ago, one of our board members, who was my age, said, who was a graduate of Salesian High School, he said, you know, when I was a junior, my mother drove me to school one day, and there were tears in her eyes when she said, you know, we can't afford to send you back. And he said, I had just taken that for granted, but I wasn't going to let that opportunity slip by. So he said, don't worry, Mom, I'll take care of it. And for the next year and a half of his life at Salesian High School, he went out and got two jobs so he could pay his tuition, which by today's standards were really rather measly. So we take things for granted and people for granted, even when we don't mean to. So that means we all need reminders, all of us, the most astute and the most caring and those who sometimes are a little bit more forgetful. We need reminders to say thank you, not only in a cursory way, but in a very reflective way. And that is why we celebrate this National Feast of Thanksgiving, and that is why so many churches, Catholic and otherwise, have some type of service or liturgy to help remind us in a communal way of the great gifts that we have received and continue to receive. We come to Mass here even though we're not able to be present physically with each other. We come to Mass because this is the big prayer of Thanksgiving that Jesus has given us and that we celebrate on a regular basis. We come to express our gratitude today for the gift of God in our lives and for the gifts that God has given us and the gifts that God puts in our way for express purpose of us receiving them and using them. Thanksgiving is also a reminder, and if we go back and think about the first Thanksgiving with the Pilgrims and the Native Americans, we go back to remind ourselves that we depend on each other and that none of us is self-made and none of us can survive and exist on our own. This Thanksgiving reminds us of that need for community and for one another. And sometimes even when we receive things, we may take them for granted as if we were entitled to receive them. So, you know, I come home on the honor roll or on the principal's list or however it is devised here now, and I may expect that my parents will reward me monetarily perhaps or with an Xbox or whatever it may happen to be because I got good grades, as if I'm entitled to get this gift because I did such and such. And this is what the gospel tells us about today. This familiar story that we've heard of the 10 lepers. You know, they were outcasts. They were unclean. And because they were outcasts and unclean, whether they had leprosy or some other skin disease, they were banned from the community. They had to be put outside the walls and they had to wander by themselves in the terrain of the desert between the villages and towns. But they could not enter the gate of any individual town because they were unclean. And so we see Jesus comes along and he cures them. He says what was supposed to be said, go show yourselves to the priest. And on the way to show themselves to the priest, did they actually realize what happened to them? Or did they take this gift of healing for granted? And it wasn't just a gift of healing, because being healed of whatever their disease was to enable them to come back into the community, to enter back into the town, to enter back with their families. It seems they took this for granted. The only one who returned, as the gospel tells us, was the person who didn't take it for granted, was, as Jesus says, a foreigner, a Samaritan. Why did he not take this for granted? The gospel doesn't say, and we don't know, but we can conjecture. Maybe because as a Samaritan, he was the odd man out in the first place. But whatever the reason, only one returned because he was aware of the gift that God had given him and aware of what that actually meant for him going forward. Thanksgiving Day, which we will celebrate on Thursday, and this Mass, which we are celebrating now, remind us that as we walk the road of our lives, not to take our growth, our friends, our family, our education, or our faith, or any of the gifts God has given us for granted. Even now, in the midst of this pandemic, and while we have opportunities perhaps to groan and complain and be sorry, we also have to stop and think, well, what have we gotten out of these weeks and months, which will continue for the foreseeable future? To use a word that has certainly been overused in the past few months, perhaps we have developed the gift of resiliency that we can, even when we fall short or fall down or don't know what to do, we can pick ourselves back up. And this goes for young people and people who are not so young as well. Perhaps it means that we become more patient. Perhaps it means that we don't take our parents so much for granted. Perhaps it means we realize that we need the people around us more than we ever did. Those are gifts that come out of even this situation that is not good. And can we be grateful for those gifts that we have received in a very unexpected way? So we're called today to reach out and say thanks. As an act of gratitude, and the best way to be grateful is to use the gifts that God has given us, both those material things and the things that come from our hearts, and to use them not only for our benefit, but for the good of our brothers and sisters around us. Every act of gratitude brings us closer to God, the giver of all gifts. to all of us here and at home. Happy Thanksgiving. And as we offer our petitions together, we pray for the needs of God's world and God's church.
The response to each petition will be, hear our prayer. For our Molloy family, brothers, teachers, staff, administrators, and students, we pray for the fulfillment of the vision of your servant Chimpanya, making your son known and loved. Let Molloy always keep Chimpanya's dream alive, instilling in its youth what it means to be Marist within our world. We pray to the Lord. For those in our nation, our world, and our Molloy community who have suffered, many of whom continue to do so, with severe, long-lasting symptoms of the coronavirus, and for the sick of our community, for those who have been devastated by recent tragedies, we know that you will take care of our loved ones and not abandon them in their time of need. May they be graced with your love and compassion to help them heal and recover. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For all in our Stanner family who've experienced the loss of a loved one since the last time we gathered for Thanksgiving, let us pause for a moment of silence to remember all of our loved ones who have passed. Lord, may we remember that their pain and the pain and the suffering of our loved ones are now over, and that they rest with you eternally in heaven. We thank you for the blessing of their being. We will always keep them in our hearts. Let your perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and the souls of all of our beloved departed, through the mercy of God, be with God eternally. We pray to the Lord. And for our own personal intentions that we keep in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer. Lord, we thank you for hearing our prayers.
Those we've expressed and those that remain in the silence of our hearts, and grant what we ask for in faith through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Is the gift to be simple, 'tis the gift to be free.
Together we pray that our offering of bread and wine may become an acceptable sacrifice before God our Father. God our Father, from whose hand we have received generous gifts, so that we might learn to share your blessings in gratitude, accept these gifts of bread and wine, and let the perfect sacrifice of Jesus draw us closer to all our brothers and sisters in the human family, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. You have entrusted to us the great gift of freedom, a gift that calls forth responsibility and commitment to the truth that all have a fundamental dignity before you. In Jesus, through his death and resurrection, we find our ultimate redemption, freedom from sin, and every blessing. And so, with hearts full of love, we join the angels today and every day of our lives to sing your glory as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Nicholas our Bishop, and all who minister to your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the Blessed Apostles, St. Marcellin Champagnat, St. Anne, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Jesus came to lead us to the Father, and so we use Jesus' words as we say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, Look rather on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We can give each other an appropriate sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. Amen. Jim, the body of Christ. And let us pray. In this celebration, O Lord, our God, you have shown us the depths of your love for all your children. Help us, we pray, to reach out in love to all your people, so that we may share with them the good things of time and eternity through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God continue to bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
I just want to take a moment to give thanks on this event of Thanksgiving for all the great gifts that we have been given. I'd like to begin, as I usually do, by thanking Father John Serio for being with us today. He came all the way from New Rochelle back home to Briarwood to Queens. We are very grateful and thankful for your presence. Thank you, Father. I'd also like to thank Mr. Klimas, who worked very hard, very quickly, to put everything together so that we can broadcast this beautiful liturgy live to you. And of course, like we've been doing for the past 7 months, but really for years, we would like to thank our wonderful IT team for putting everything together and making this all happen. Finally, I'd like just to give a very hearty thank you from everybody here at Molloy to all you, our faculty, our staff, our parents, our students, our administration, and our alumni, our entire Molloy community. This year has been challenging, to say the least, but time and time again, we have seen how you have risen to the occasion and accomplished many, many great things. We are indeed tremendously thankful for you, for this Molloy community, for all you have done, and all that you will continue to do. So again, on behalf of everybody here, to everybody watching via the live stream, happy Thanksgiving. And now, at this point, students, you are to end this live stream and proceed directly to your third period Zoom. This will be the quickest commute to a class you have ever had. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. God bless you all.